What's up, everybody? Today I'm going to show you how to create closed captions and upload to YouTube as easily and fast as possible. All right, the first thing you want to do is go to your YouTube studio. You'll go to your account and then you scroll down to the right and go to your studio for your content creators page. And once in your studio, you hit your videos, your content. And this is a fairly new channel for me. I only had it for a week. I'm just barely working with this. I have two other channels, but we're gonna mess with one of these videos here. This is a short video, so what I'm gonna do is double click this. So once you get to your video, you wanna go to your Otter app. So how do you get Otter? Well, you're gonna go to your Google Play Store or whichever device Play Store you use, like Apple or whatnot. I'm on Android, so I'm gonna go to Google Play Store and I'm gonna type in Otter. I already have it installed, but this is what you're gonna be looking for. This blue one right here. Just tap on that, or the app itself, you're gonna install it and then you're gonna hit open. You're gonna look for the O with the two eyes right there. Basically a audio symbol. And then once you open it, that's what it's gonna look like. So you know you have the right app. And I'll try to put the link in the details or in the description box if I can snag the link. You know, open up your app. And then what you want to do is place your phone next to your speaker, like so. And then play this video in YouTube. So this is one of the videos I did, but we'll use this one as an example. So once you get to this part, you're going to want to hit the record button. Let me show you the record button real quick. You're going to want to hit this record button in the bottom right corner. When you're about to record, make sure you don't have a TV playing or anything like that, or anybody talking in the background, because that will mess up your recording. So what you're going to do is hit record on your phone and then play right after that and let it record everything. So I'm going to show you what it looks like while it's recording.
Alright, what we got here is an S part. Already reset this one, but I'll show you guys how to reset it. What you need is like a paper clip or something small to hit this little reset hole right here. Like, you can put your paper clip in there. I'm gonna use this little screwdriver here. I'm pushing. Go through the little questions, reset your time and your hours, and then everything should pop back up. Thanks for watching.
So as you can see, we're gonna go back on this, go back to your studio on that one. It's gonna say now processing. Once it's finished processing, I'm gonna get an email report saying that it's done. So what you're gonna do while that's processing, you're gonna go to Google. Let me close this, I already have it open. So I'm gonna go to Google, go to Google search, and you hit Otter. You're gonna have little Otter pictures pop up and everything, but what you wanna need to go to is where it says HTTPS Otter, www.otter, and you're gonna click here. You're gonna set up, or since you already set up your account on your phone, all you'll have to do is sign in. As you can see, it popped up right here without me even logging in, because I already have an account with Otter, so my password, everything's already set up. When you come here, all you're gonna do is set up or type in your email that you used and the password that you use for your phone, and you're going to be coming to your home page here. And the one on the top would be the one I just recorded, and that's going to have everything in it. So what we're going to do is click on that. As you can see here, everything's timestamped, all your text is here. Sometimes you're going to have more than speaker one, it's going to pick up different speakers and it's going to be listed down here, but for this video it's kind of short. And everything was spoken clearly. I had a problem with other videos where there was a lot of background noise, and YouTube and the auto sync wouldn't work. It didn't work at all. So make sure in your videos that your speech is clear so it can translate and type to text for you, or speech to text for you clearly. So we'll go here to the top. If you want to edit this, I'd advise reading it and it'll play like this. Check it out.
What we got here is an S-PAR heater control. Usual problem is a carrier code that says maintenance.
So required. I'm going to hit pause on this. What you're going to do is you're just going to listen to everything, make sure everything that you said is correctly spelt and worded in there properly. A lot of parts, for the most part, when you have a video, you're not speaking clearly or there's a lot of background noise, it'll come up spelled differently and whatnot. So I already went through this and it's typed out fairly well. I only made a couple edits. So once you do all that, you're going to highlight everything here. And you're going to see a little text bar up top. You're going to go to the fifth one over. It's going to say copy. You can edit here if you want to edit any of this. There's your little edit pin right there. You're going to click that edit. And you'll be able to type in here while it's playing. It's a little distracting, but you just click in here and edit whatever you need to edit. But for this part, we're going to go to copy. We're going to copy text. It has all the timestamps in there, everything you're going to need. So you're going to go back to your YouTube studio. Mine's a little bit different. The explanation for that is I have TubeBuddy. If you want to up your tag game, get TubeBuddy. I'll have the link in the description. You can get a 20% discount off of that. That actually fixes your tags. Just a little quick run through here. You have your YouTube tags here, and it'll give you optional tags. This is my other channel. It's not the pro. This is a free version. It'll give you a few tags in here that work good with your video. There's a bunch more that's usually listed down here. I have that on one of my main videos, but you can actually see what your ranking score is for those tags. As you can see, I picked fairly good tags for this video. It helps your search engine. Not only will you have that, now you'll have your closed caption in there actually acts as a tag, so everything you say in your video will count as a tag and help you in your searches. So now we're going to go over to subtitles in the bottom left. But that's why my screen's a little different, just to let you guys know. So we're going to set language. We're going to go English, of course. You can translate in any language you like. But for now, we're just going to click English, United States. And make this default for my channel. I can add other languages. Then hit confirm. So now we have two in here. So I'm going to click this English, United States, video, language, blah, blah, blah. We're going to go over to the right and we're going to hit add. So now you have this option here. It's been changed. So a lot of videos you'll see out there is a little bit different. But we're going to go to auto sync on the left and click that. And it's going to give you a little caption bar, because this is a new channel. My old channel, I don't have all this, but just to show you guys, so this is kind of what it'll look like, what you guys get. So automatically map text in the timeline. Simply type the text you hear in the video and it'll automatically get synced. So what we're going to do, we already have it copied and pasted from the Otter page. So I'm gonna go control V to paste, or you can just go right click and paste, same thing. And then you just want to scroll through here and make sure all your spelling is correct. And as you can see, S-PAR says it's not spelled correctly, but it is. We'll just change it to S-PAR heater, whatever, doesn't matter. But it's S-PAR. So now we're gonna let it upload. As you can see right here, it's already uploaded, and it's already timed in, because on the Otter app it actually timestamps all the captions, and then along with YouTube, the auto sync will actually, it'll work together and precisely upload your captions to your video. So here's the timeline here. If you want to scroll through your timeline, you got to fix anything, here's your little scroll bar down here. Let me move it for you so you can see. You can go through any part of your video. As you can see, all the text is already in there and put in the right time. That was pretty fast. So we can hit play and double check everything.
What we got here is an S-PAR heater control.
You can see your captions pop up right here.
The usual problem is a error code that says.
And what you're gonna do is just double check, make sure the timing is correct. And I never had any problems with this, so I'm not even gonna check it. If you want to edit times, you can go in here and click that, but I'm not, just for time's sake of watching this video, so you guys can get through this video and go to fixing your videos and adding closed captions. So when you get all that done, you're going to go up to publish. So once published, it says changes saved, processing may take a few hours. Actually, it does take a while for it to upload, but once it's in there, by the next day, you're already getting your video retagged, being placed in other places you possibly couldn't have it before because your tags are limited. And it really sucks. Like that video I just did, it's limited to what I have in the description. As you can see, I put a really good description in here just to get those tags added in the description bar for more accessibility to YouTube people searching videos and whatnot. And then whatever you had in the title along with the tags you have in your video down here. So now you have a closed caption added to your search terms because a new AI system does count that and it does pick it up, and it has been confirmed by the larger channels on YouTube. So if you like the video, hopefully you'll subscribe. I'll be putting out more YouTube videos coming up. I'm just trying to remove videos from my other channels to make videos for YouTube, just not they're in their niche base area. So anyhow, that should save you about $2 a minute. That's what they usually cost is. So if you have a video that's like, say, 60 minutes long, that'll cost you about $120 to do what I just showed you. And everything there is free. The Otter app for your phone is free. The Otter app online is free. There's a free extension in that link for TubeBuddy if you like that as well. That's in there. And if you like the pro version, try that out. It's $9 a month, but if you buy the annual subscriptions, like $7.20 a month. But with my link, you'll get a 20% discount on that. So if you need help, I suggest open up a second window with the video I just had up there and do it step by step by doing that and compare it to your video and where you're at on uploading the closed captions, and just go through the video step by step and you should be doing okay. And if you have problems, then you'd have to figure out what it is. Usually what I had, the biggest problem was ambient noise in the background of the video I had. So there it is. If you would like for me to do the captions, I probably could do it for you via email. If you need help, leave a comment in the description below with your email. I can probably do the subtitles for about $1 a minute because, yeah, time is money, basically. So if you like the video, hit the like button. If you like my channel, either one, the other channel, Shadow Mafia Paranormal, this one's Gears and Fire. There's one other channel, but it has nothing to do with either of this, so a subscription would be awesome. Thank you guys for watching.